Hello, people, and welcome to News BTC's We Need to Crypto Talk, a show in which we invite seasoned and upcoming talents of Bitcoin and blockchain industry and discuss the enormous possibilities decentralized tool can offer to mankind. I, Yashu, am fortunate to speak to our special guest today. That is Anuj Bairathi, the CEO and founder of HashGames. So without further ado, let's speak to the guy himself. Hello, Anuj. How are you doing today?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thank you. And thanks for having me here.
It's a pleasure, sir. And we'll just jump right away to the first question itself. Cloud mining. I've read about your company HashGains and it's into cloud mining business. And so I'll just simply start with, you know, how you guys work and where are you located? Where are you registered? Can you just start by giving us some little details about your company?
So, well, you have asked about cloud mining. Let me tell you about cloud mining first. So, basically, in a blockchain, whatever transactions are happening is being recorded on a ledger, and that particular ledger, a block is created for storing data. So that's basically validating those transactions is particularly called as mining. When you are doing it on a cloud, thousands of machines working together for a same kind of a output, it becomes a cloud. Then even if some machine goes down, your output doesn't affect is something are the few important significance and the benefits of cloud. As far as we are concerned, HashGains is operating in this space for last 1 year. About our company Cyfuture, basically we have experience of more than 15 years into IT services, particularly data centers. So we have been operating our data center at multiple places in India. And we have relationships and partnerships with US and European data centers. We have our own data centers in Delhi NCR and Jaipur, Rajasthan. So our experience goes 15 years into this particular cloud hosting industry. We have been watching this blockchain industry for last 6-7 years very closely. And mining operations on a commercial scale have started around a year back.
That's very interesting to know, sir. But India has always been a very center spot when it comes to cloud mining Ponzi schemes. We have seen that in the form of gainbitcoins.com that stole away millions of rupees from Indian investors. And it is not returning the money, as we can see. The guy is sitting somewhere in Dubai hiding with all that funds. In that climate, in this very climate, when you are trying to attract investment from the people, how do you want to approach them, and how can you make sure that you are legitimate?
So, well, there can be various schemes. People can launch various schemes. There are Ponzi schemes, as you have rightly said. But see, investor has to be cautious himself while they are investing into any such programs, any such schemes or any such plan. I do not have a lot of idea of what that person did. But as far as if you talk about the schemes which are operating out of this particular market, people say that, OK, you can invest in Bitcoin and your returns are fixed. Every month you would have a fixed returns. You would be getting your returns on a monthly basis, which are fixed. I do not think anybody in this world can commit any kind of a whatsoever. There's a reason behind it. Bitcoin is highly volatile. If you talk about maybe Bitcoin, you talk about any cryptocurrency for that matter, it is highly volatile and it changes. So your return also changes. And anybody committing fixed return, that you would be getting this kind of a return, that they do in a pyramid schemes or a Ponzi schemes, they commit. You are investing XYZ amount, you would be getting 10% on a monthly basis every time till the operation, whatever it is, the tip of that particular contract. So what I'm trying to say is all that is not possible. It is because you're in this particular mining industry, what happens? Your difficulty changes, competition increases, number of miners goes up, the prices of a currency changes. So all these things are happening, how can your returns be definite? It can be. But past trend of history shows that people who have invested in this mining programs have got returns. But the first sign of distinguishing between a fake and a genuine provider is to first understand whether the returns they are committing are fixed or not. So as far as we are concerned, saying we are just not committing any kind of a returns, it is dependent on various factors, market conditions, and the returns may be higher, may be lower. We have a mining calculator on our website which has a clear disclaimer. It says clearly that we are not committing anything. It is dependent on various factors, and it may change. It may go up, it may go down also.
Perfect.
So talking about other providers, investor has to have an understanding. Anybody committing fixed returns is all bogus. There is absolutely no possibility of committing any kind of fixed return.
So moving to my next question, you have mentioned that the returns cannot be fixed. They can be very fluctuatory. So can you tell us that what kind of coins are you mining to make sure that people have such diversity in ensuring that if there is an increasing in mining difficulty in one coin, the algorithm can shift to other coins to mine more profitable coins? Do you have more coins in your bucket right now as far as Bitcoin and others are concerned?
So, well, yes, we are providing such services for around 8 or 9 crypto coins at the moment. And we would be increasing that particular capability to multiple coins. So there are a lot of hundreds of mineable coins. But at the moment, the coins which we have picked up have the best profitability in terms of returns. Because whenever you are doing any mining, there has to be, what do you mine? You have to mine the transactions. So in a currency which has a lesser transactions, the mining competition is less, but again your return goes up as more miners come up. So it's always good, and it's always a better strategy to mine such coins which have millions of transactions, in which so that's the reason why we have taken some top 10 cryptocurrencies which we mine, wherein the transactions are huge, and we get to mine them and have better returns as compared to others.
So which do you think is the most profitable currency in these times in mining?
So it changes again. It changes every day.
No, some
day
on a normal average, because so, Bitcoin has not become very profitable lately because of the increased in difficulty itself, and the maintenance fees is very high for Bitcoin itself.
At the moment, Bitcoin Cash is the most profitable mining coin at the moment. But it changes. Bitcoin may become better tomorrow, or maybe even Ethereum can become better. So, but overall, in last 6-8 months, what we have witnessed is the competition and the returns are either better with Bitcoin Cash or Bitcoin itself. So,
oh, that's great. Well, I'll now move to the very physicality of your operation, that is the mining facility. Where is it? You have mentioned that you have data centers in Rajasthan and Delhi, right? I'm sorry, it's NCR. So do you have mining facilities always, like, have you set it up, or you're trying to build it more? Are you trying to buy machines right now? So where are you standing right now in terms of that?
So, well, as I mentioned, we are a data center providers. We are cloud hosting providers for many years. So we have got a relationship and tie-ups in US, China, Europe also. And we have facilities in India also. So we have put up the cloud mining setup across all the facilities. So it is divided at the moment. So we are doing it from the multiple places at the moment. And the future plan is that we want to build mega mining cloud data mining centers in Rajasthan and Canada, because Rajasthan is a place wherein you have ample solar energy. And while in Canada, the cost of a power which is being offered and incentives government is offering are very good to do all such mining operations there.
Well, but don't you think that Rajasthan is still a very hot place to conduct mining operations? The kind of cooling equipment you'll be requiring will kind of like increase the cost of mining itself.
Well, see, the thing is that the cost of a power in a maybe in a colder area is say 12 cents. That's a normal cost of a power, the average median cost. While the cost which we are able to work out in Rajasthan is around 3 cents to around 4 cents. So that's just 30%. So
okay, that's cheaper.
I would say even if the cooling cost goes up 20% because of you are saying the surroundings are hot.
Yeah.
Even after that, you are at least you are at around 40-50% of the industry average, which makes it highly competitive. Because see, in a cloud mining data centers, these devices themselves generate a lot of heat. So when the heat generated by these devices are so high, so even if you are you have to put anyways precision air conditioners of a very heavy duty precision air conditioners, which are normally used in data center.
So it's achievable. Down the line, it's achievable. You're saying that.
Okay. So what may happen in a colder area versus a hot area is that you may have to put lesser cooling capacities in a colder area while you have to put little more. So we understand that particular thing changes. The cost goes up by 5-10% overall operational cost, I would say. But eventually the cost of a power is so cheap, as in the cost of a power is actually virtually free, as in there is absolutely no cost. But the capex, the capital you have to put in infrastructure, and there's a cost for that. That's how we are deriving a cost of around 3-4 cents per unit of a power. Even after that, the overall running cost remains very, very cost effective. Moreover, the most important fact is you can't continue to use fossil fuels for that has become a concern area as far as cloud mining is concerned, because people are now saying that it consumes a lot of
power. For environment. Yeah.
So when you are using green renewable energy, that's you are even not hurting environment, and obviously you are not using fossil fuels. So eventually you are saving and protecting environment. So the multiple benefits are there. And in Rajasthan, there's an ample availability of a wind power also. So wind works 24 hours a day. Solar works for maybe 12 hours a day. So overall, you have a consistent power available 24 hours a day.
That's good to know. And my next question is directed towards regulation itself. See, in India, we still are in sort of a gray area right now when it comes to regulating bitcoins. And the government has already said that it cannot be used as a major form of exchange, and it's not a legal tender. It has been cleared right now, but they have not been very much vocal about minting it. Whoever who is mining Bitcoin, they still do not have any clear ample laws for that. Are you in touch with any government authorities regarding the regulatory part of this entire business you are building?
So basically, see, we our core business is to put up machines and to carry out transactions. So we are saying it is mining. See, what is mining? Mining is nothing but validation of transactions through some machines, through some hardware.
Right.
So we are a data center providers. We have to put up machines and have to validate transactions. Eventually, the returns are coming in the form of a Bitcoin, because when you are putting up, see, we have a lot of banks as our customers. So banks are doing transaction worth billions of dollars from the servers which are hosted in our data center farms.
Right.
We do not get any, the kind of a remuneration we are getting for hosting those servers are in local currency, in USD or maybe a fiat currency. But when you are validating, that's what the beauty of this particular distributed ledger or a blockchain industry is. It's decentralized, peer-to-peer. So there is no central authority, and hence when there is no central authority, you can't expect the payment from somebody for doing the transactions, and eventually you would be getting the rewards. So government in India is planning to get into blockchain in coming months or years. So eventually, when it is a blockchain, it is a distributed, decentralized. So they would have to eventually think of rewarding people by some way of cryptocurrency only. I do not see, even if you have seen interview of South Korean finance minister.
Right. Oops.
And the rewards can come in form of a cryptocurrency. So as far as we are concerned, absolutely no regulations or nothing has come up by government. Government has come up and said anything. As far as our operations are concerned, it's pretty much into the line of how the way government works and we are operating. Now coming back to government, said it's not a legal tender. Mm-hmm. If it is legal tender, that is being said by some other countries also. But it's an asset. Government has not clarified. The government has formed a committee which has to come up with its report. So I do not think there is any kind of government may block exchanges, but as far as these validation of transactions are something what we are talking about, I do not see there is any kind of a challenge in doing executing such things.
Good to know that, sir. And moving to the nitty gritty part of this interview, and this is going to be the last section. It's about the ICO you are doing. Why there is the need to do an ICO for an established company such as yours? No VCs there for you guys?
Oh well, there are a lot of VCs available, but see, in this particular cryptocurrency world, there is a new way to raise capital. Instead of you talking to VCs, you can go to millions of people and can ask and raise money from them, so that they also benefit from how your business grows. They also become investors, they also become virtual partners in the business. That's what the beauty is, and I always believe that if it is always good to distribute wealth among thousands and millions of people instead of distributing it to just one venture capitalist.
So how much you are raising, and how much you're raising it for? What are you trying to build with the money you are raising right now?
So the hard cap is around $30 million, and we are planning to raise it for building mega data centers in Rajasthan and Canada. That's what the plan is. Build two data centers, and the returns which would be generated out of these data centers would be distributed to investors in form of dividends, in form of payouts, and so on.
All right. And how can people contribute to your this ICO you're doing?
So well, people, our ICO is a Ethereum blockchain based ICO, and people can go to our website and they can participate. They can sign up. They can participate in ICO. They can subscribe for the number of tokens they are interested in. The other advantages which we are offering with our tokens is we are giving free mining power. Pushing power, so that people can experience how this particular cloud mining industry works. So first hand experience coming at virtually no cost, and then we are saying that our tokens would be giving dividends for the profits which we would be generating. We plan to distribute it in the form of dividends to our investors. So that is another thing. The third thing is, if we are saying it's convertible tokens, people can convert these tokens for buying any service which is being offered at HashGains, and other discounts which are being offered. So we are saying that our tokens would have multiple benefits, multiple use. How investors can benefit from the tokens? See, so many ICOs coming up, they virtually are just an idea. As far as we are concerned, It's a running profitable business already, and top of it, the mining has always been a profitable business for the cloud miners, and the capacity which we would be putting up from the capital we raise from this ICO would go to build mining operations of a large capacity, and that particular operation would eventually return profits, and that would be distributed.
Thank you very much for that elaborated piece, Anuj, and we hope that your company does what it sets out to doing, build many more mining facilities around the world. So thank you very much for speaking to us.
Thank you very much.